am resurrection and I am life, says the Lord. Whoever has faith in me shall have life, even though he die. And everyone who has life and has committed himself to me in faith shall not die forever. As for me, I know that my Redeemer lives and that at the last he will stand upon the earth. After my awaking, he will raise me up, and in my body I shall see God. I myself shall see, and my eyes behold him who is my friend and not a stranger. For none of us has life in himself, and none becomes his own master when he dies. For if we have life, we are alive in the Lord, and if we die, we die in the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's possession. Happy from now on are those who die in the Lord. So it is, says the Spirit, for they rest from their labors. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, whose mercies cannot be numbered, accept our prayers on behalf of your servant, Carolyn, and grant her an entrance into the land of light and joy in the fellowship of your saints, through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated for the readings.
I'm going to read the 23rd Psalm if you'd like to join me. Okay. Pardon me. Reading from the Revelation to John. And I saw the holy city, the New Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throng saying, "See, the home of God is among mortals. He will dwell with them. They will be his people. And God himself will be with them. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. Death will be no more. Mourning and crying and pain will be no more. For the first things have passed away." And the one who was seated on the throne said, "See, I am making all things new." Also he said, "Write this, for these words are trustworthy and true." Then he said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty I will give water as a gift from the spring of the water of life. Those who conquer will inherit these things, and I will be their God, and they will be my children." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us read in unison Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anointed my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Standing as you are able, you may open up the yellow songbook for the song In the Garden, song number 95. Jesus Christ, according to John. Jesus said, "Very truly I tell you, anyone who hears my word and believes him who sent me has eternal life and does not come under judgment, but has passed from death to life. Very truly I tell you, the hour is coming and is now here, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. For just as the Father has life in himself, so he has granted the Son also to have life in himself. And he has given him authority to execute judgment, because he is the Son of Man." The Gospel of the Lord. I speak these words to you in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please be seated. Good afternoon and welcome to St. Stephen's. We are here to say thank you to God and to celebrate the life and resurrection of Carolyn, known as mom, known as sister, known as friend, as companion learners, neighbors in the process of life. You know better than I stories of light and life with Carolyn. And yet the time I have known of her and known with her, she sparkles to me. When I think of Carolyn, I feel and remember joy. Seeing her come into the space just outside of our worship space, we call it the narthex, accompanied by her faithful son, Ken, who brought her to church. And she was so excited to get to be here in this place. And even when she wasn't here on Sundays, she would also come to Eucharist at Episcopal Place. Faithful, musical, bright, smarter than she would let on. A heart full of love for her family, for her friends, for her pets, for her plants that flowered because she cared for them. And if you knew Carolyn, you flowered too because she cared for and loved you. Carolyn was a traveler, an adventurer, dancing, playing music, creating spaces of beauty, and always curious. With her book club, she fervently read. I heard stories told of how she would have books in multiple rooms. And she could read multiple books at once. She would just pick up the book that was in this room and read a chapter, and then later on in another room, pick up another book. What gifts for filling herself with information, with knowledge, with understanding, with things of this world, and also pursuing matters of faith and understanding God more deeply. I think you would say that Carolyn had an unwavering faith, and she did. And in the near end of her life, she held fast to that faith, even when she was scared. I think that's a great testament and a great witness for us, to be faithful even when we are scared and hurting and uncertain of what is to come. And so as we hear in our scripture today, those readings that her family helped choose on her behalf were ones of promise and comfort and hope. And those decisions are easy to come by when we think about Carolyn. Promise and comfort and hope. Because Carolyn was confident in the promise of Jesus and God's love for her. She knows now that home of God that we hear about in Revelation, where death will be no more, where mourning and crying and pain will be no more. For she is loosed from the bonds of this life. And that's why we have a celebration. We have a white frontal. We have our paschal candle. This is an Easter feast, a feast of resurrection and hope. Now, that doesn't mean that it's bad for us to have tears in our eyes, because a hole is left in our lives in her absence, and yet we get to say thank you to God for the gift of Carolyn, for her fervor, for her compassion. So my hope is that as we all go out into the world, these words of faithfulness that we have read together and heard proclaimed, we will live into those. Jesus said to his friends, "Very truly, I tell you, anyone who hears my word and believes him who sent me has eternal life. Let us cling to those words of hope, of compassion, and promise, so that we too may pass from death into eternal life, and that those things and reminders around us of Carolyn will remind us of the hope of eternal life, so that when we see a black, skittish cat like Midnight, who refuses to be engaged or petted, we will remember that Carolyn's beloved cat is also a creature of God, is a reminder of hope and comfort and joy and faith. I hope in the days to come you will share stories with one another of Carolyn and how she has changed your life. For she is now among the saints. We'll gather and have a meal, a sacramental meal of communion in just a moment, where we say that we're joining with the communion of saints, where Carolyn is now. So it's our work now to hold on to those remembrances of her and to tell others the story, because that's how we received the Gospels. That's how we continue to be inspired by the revelation of John and the Holy Scripture, because we tell the story. So, whether it's music, nature, books, a favorite memory, hold tight to Carolyn and yet know that she is in the arms of God, and it's now your work to continue dancing, playing music, reading in curiosity, and loving God the best you can. And for that, thanks be to God. We continue now standing as we are able, turning to page 7 in your bulletin. In the assurance of eternal life given at baptism, let us proclaim our faith and say, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Continuing on page 8 with the prayers of the people, for our sister Carolyn, let us pray to our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am resurrection and I am life. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Carolyn and dry the tears of those who weep. You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow. You raised the dead to life. Give to our sister eternal life. You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our sister to the joys of heaven. Our sister was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give her fellowship with all your saints. She was nourished with your body and blood. Grant her a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom. Comfort us in our sorrows at the death of our sister Carolyn. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope. Father of all, we pray to you for Carolyn and for all those whom we love but see no longer. Grant to them eternal rest. Let light perpetual shine upon them. May her soul and the souls of all the departed through the mercy of God rest in peace. Amen. Amen. The peace of Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
Please be seated. If you're joining us on YouTube, welcome to this service as we remember and say thank you to God for Carolyn. I'm glad that you can join us even though you are far away, or maybe just at Episcopal Place down the road, but I'm glad you are here. And for you who are here in person, again, welcome. We transition in our service now to a sacramental meal where we say thank you to God through blessing bread and wine. And the culmination of that is that we all will gather and share a bit of this meal. So all are welcome to come to the rail and extend your hands like this to receive the bread. You may either dip it in the wine or take a sip of the wine. If you choose to abstain, you may simply cross your hands over your chest to receive a blessing. We also have gluten-free wafers. If you are unable to come forward, we can come out to you. As communion was an important piece of Carolyn's life, and especially in her last days, please know that you are all invited to take part in this meal. And as this is a time for us to join near to God and one another, let us now lift up our hearts as we offer indeed our whole life to God. And as you feel comfortable, you may sing along, "Morning Has Broken," number 8 in your hymnal, 1982, in the pew.
Please stand as you're able. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who rose victorious from the dead and comforts us with the blessed hope of everlasting life. For to your faithful people, O Lord, life is changed, not ended. And where our mortal bodies lie in death, there is prepared for us a dwelling place eternal in the heavens. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your words spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the Word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink this, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death. We proclaim his resurrection. We await his coming in glory. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where, with all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters through Jesus Christ, our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us. The gifts of God for you, the people of God. This is the table, not of the church, but of the Lord. It is made ready for those who love him and for those who want to love him more. So come, you who have much faith and you who have little, you who have been here often and you who have not been here long, you who have tried to follow and you who have failed. Come, because it's the Lord who invites you. It is his will that those who want him should meet him here. Let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you that in your great love you have fed us with the spiritual food and drink of the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, and have given us a foretaste of your heavenly banquet. Grant that the sacrament may be to us a comfort in affliction, and a pledge of our inheritance in that kingdom where there is no death, neither sorrow nor crying, but the fullness of joy with all your saints, through Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. I invite you to stand for the commendation.
Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints.
Where sorrow and pain are no more,
neither sighing, but life everlasting. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of mankind, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and to earth we shall return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints,
where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but life everlasting. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant, Carolyn. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen.
The Lord bless and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you now and remain with you always. Amen. Let us go forth in the name of Christ. Alleluia, alleluia.